greetings to you, Crocoduck Army. Well, election 2017 is in the books. The election is unfortunately not as big as 2016, but it certainly went a lot better. There were two governor's races, both in New Jersey and in my state of Virginia, as well as some special elections, local elections, and ballot measures of various types. Democrats completed about as clean a sweep as you're going to see in an off-cycle election. Republicans are now scrambling to figure out how to retain their House of Representatives majority in the election next year. With Trump's approval rating dropping by the day with no end in sight, it's hard to imagine a more dire scenario for them. Even more Republicans are going to start bailing on the orange dumpster fire now. In New Jersey, the combative, scandal-plagued Trump sycophant Chris Christie was term-limited, but his lieutenant governor tried to carry on his entitled legacy for him. She failed and was beaten decisively, as expected. In Virginia, which was a slightly closer race, we already had a Democratic governor, also term-limited, but his lieutenant governor, Ralph Northam, won by 8 percentage points. That race was more interesting because his opponent, former George W. Bush and RNC stooge Ed Gillespie, tried to hit Trumpish themes in his campaign ads, like Confederate statues, NFL protests, and fear of criminal immigrants from Latin America. He tried to be just like Trump in order to pander to racists and social conservatives, but didn't really want to link his name to Trump. The voters weren't buying it, and he lost in such landslides in the population centers that the rural areas didn't even keep it that close. In the Virginia state legislature races, Republicans had 66 of the 100 seats in the lower house, but now it looks like it will end up 50-50 pending recounts. One Democrat is ahead by less than 100 votes, so every vote counts. Another very telling fact about those state house races is that it appears that statewide, Democrats got about 55% of the total vote. But because the state offices and legislature in 2010 were Republican, gerrymandering the districts in their favor saved them about 5 seats. Now in 2020, Democrats will have a lot more power in the redistricting process, which will likely cost Republicans state and federal seats in 2021 and beyond. This is why I'm happy that there was a fair amount of unity among Democrats, despite Northam being too centrist for many people's tastes, including mine. People knew what was at stake with the alternative, though, and they came out to vote anyway. The right place to have those fights is in the primaries, and unless the candidate is a total asshat, then you close ranks and get the win. I have many ideals, but there are no moral victories in politics. Trump needs to be sent a message, and the message was sent. Many new progressive lawmakers can now work their way to the top. This election also showed that revenge for jackasses is a dish best served cold. In New Jersey, local Republican Representative John Carman made a joke about the Women's March the day after Trump's inauguration on social media. It was something about how women hopefully would be back in time to make dinner after the protest, which is, of course, endlessly hilarious and original, right, ladies? Women and their love of cooking, am I right? No? Yeah, I thought probably not. The same guy also drew some heat for wearing a patch with a Confederate flag on it, while oddly representing a state hundreds of miles north of the old Confederate lines. A woman named Ashley Bennett defeated him for that seat. She was inspired to run by her opponent's words. In Virginia, Danica Rome defeated a 13-term incumbent Republican, Bob Marshall. Bob is a bigoted tool who wrote one of those anti-trans bathroom bills that fortunately didn't get signed into law. She campaigned on that issue and on local traffic issues that we in the Northern Virginia suburbs of D.C. always face. So, how is this one revenge? Danica Rome is a trans woman. Poetic justice indeed. Next year's election will be even bigger, with over 30 states selecting new governors, many of whom are term-limited Republicans that should be easy pickups, as well as the House and a third of the Senate. The gerrymandering advantage comes into play in many states, but if Democrats get a wave like they did this year, like I said last week, the House will flip to the Democrats and Trump's agenda will be cut off at the knees. For now, we continue to resist, disrupt, and vote like your life depends on it, because when it comes to health care, you know someone's life will depend on it. Until next time, Crocoduck Army, as McCree from Overwatch might say, always take out a bunch of bad guys at the same time.
Oh, let's break it! Damn!
It's time.
Sitting there.